trying to live down that golf thing. How do you know this flies out of your hands? Listen, let's get on to a happier subject, and that is holidays. The holiday grocery shopping, does that make you worry? Well, worry no more, because super shopper Susan Samter is back for part three of her series, Cashing In with Coupons. She's going to show us how to take advantage of holiday bargains. Now, you mean we can save money at holidays? I would think it'd just be just the opposite.
Well, a lot of people think that. As a matter of fact, a typical holiday dinner would probably cost you close to $50 if you were going to invite your family and give them all of the trimmings that go with your dinner. But if you're able to keep in mind that couponing and refunding can help you a lot at the holiday time, you should be able to save not only that $50, but some money in between. You might want to start off, especially with coming into Easter time and some other holidays, with a ham or a turkey. Uh-huh. And some of the companies, what they do is they offer you money back on the purchase of your turkey or your ham. In this case, it was Reynolds Wrap. And you remember we were talking about coupon combining.
Yes.
Well, I had to go out and buy that Reynolds Wrap, but I used a coupon first, 35 cents off, and my store doubled it. And then I was able to get back $2 on the purchase of the ham. And so that started off at least my holiday dinner.
Right.
But if your guests come in and they're famished and you like to give them a little something to start them off with, I like to put out little dips and chips and so on. Lipton said that if you buy Lipton, they will give you back not money on Lipton soup. They'll give you money back to get your free potato chips. So I can take these potato chips, make some Lipton onion dip, and put it out, and I won't have to pay anything. So you can get almost everything you want to serve.
Okay, I don't know real Cajun potato chips.
I know he was excited about this spot. I didn't know why.
You want to try one?
And then, of course, if for your drinks...
Now, that's a real Cajun potato.
Okay. There'll be lots of them in the mailbox, won't there? Okay.
Well, actually, that's another thing that happens when you become a refunder and a couponer. When you start sending in for refunders, you become a test person to get new samples in the mail. I remember when I had my children, not that this has to do with holidays, and I used to send in for refunds on diapers. Every time new diapers became improved and better and prettier, samples and coupons. And then the same thing with baby cereal. Fill out this questionnaire and we'll send you more coupons. So that's another byproduct of couponing and refunding. You get on mailing lists free samples and coupons.
All right.
But if you're going to be shopping for your holidays and you even your drinks, even you can get your bread and your baking. I got free apples just because I was going to make a pie to serve at my dinner.
And you get free lettuce?
And free lettuce, and that came also all you
I
had to do.
Is that true with ice cream? I mean, if I get on a list, they'll send me.
No, they're going to
send
ice cream.
Well, that's a little bit hard to go through the mail, but all of the holidays, every time there's a holiday, every time there's an event, manufacturers use that as a time to promote their product and to get you to buy their product. As a good shopper, if you use that, for example, they even said that if I buy film, they're going to send me back either $1 or $2. So I went out and got the film, and on the back of the film is another $1. So if you
keep... So wonder they can make money.
Well, actually, sometimes you can come out ahead of the game. You even make money on the products, because if the product costs a dollar and you have a dollar coupon, that's for free, and then I'm going to send it in and get another dollar back.
Susan Samter, it's terrific. There seems to be no end, and fortunately, there isn't, because we'll be back with Susan tomorrow. Don't go away, though. Smokey Robinson will sing you a love song next. I'm glad to hear that. Did you know that this bottle of ketchup can save you money on your family meat bill? Yes, it can. Here today to show us how is that smart shopper, Susan Samter, with part four of her series, Cashing In with Coupons. Susan, nice to have you back. This is a great series, tremendous reaction from the audience. How does ketchup save money on meat?
Well, it's a very unusual type of a refund, but companies have said that they wanted to make their product more unique. They want you to remember them. So Heinz has come out for the last, I would say, 8 years with the following offer. If you buy Heinz ketchups or relishes, they'll send you back money, not on your Heinz ketchups or relishes, but on meat. If you send in one label, you get back $1, two labels, $2, and so on. And this is a coupon that comes back looking something like this. You can go to any store that you want, buy any kind of meat that you want, beef or chicken or whatever, and you're able to save money on your meat bill. So companies want to make themselves more unique. They want you to remember ketchup, so that even if it's 6 months after the offer, you thought, gee, I got free meat from the ketchup.
Susan, do you know how long it takes to use a bottle of ketchup? They're great. What, John? Listen, So you buy 10 bottles of ketchup so you can get this meat. I think it's a great idea, but it's just...
The slower
it comes out of the bottle, the slower you're going to get your meat, I suppose.
That's true, and if you only could get one label, you're only going to get back $1. But what refunders do, and that's what makes us a little smarter, is we save our labels in advance of the offer. I know this offer comes out once a year because it's called their annual barbecue and refund back. So I save my labels as I use the Heinz ketchups or the relishes or the pickles, and that's one of the good things about refunding. You can save your labels in advance of the offer.
That's a good idea.
You use coupons in the play Checkmates,
yes,
don't you?
Yes, I do. And I was looking
at one
for that.
Have you ever used a coupon in real life?
Oh, yes. A lot of times. You know, and now there's a lot of discount houses, but you have to buy in large quantities. So coupons are still a very good way for people who don't have a lot of money to them. And have to go to the supermarket.
Some more items, Susan.
Well, some of the other things that are called tie-ins, if you want to buy Dole pineapple, let's say you like Dole pineapple, and they want you to remember Dole. Why is Dole better than Del Monte or any other brand? Well, you can get $2 back on your purchase of chicken. So if you buy the Dole and you send in the little proof of purchase that you see on the back of that can, you send it in right with this little certificate, you get back a $2 coupon that says good on the purchase of chicken.
I've been missing all of this.
And why do they say it is because they want you to make Hawaiian chicken. Of course, you don't have to make
Hawaiian.
You don't
have to, do you? They don't check up on it if you don't make it. Okay.
As a matter of fact, many times these refunds come back in the form of cash. And you can put that into a regular bank account, and it's non-interest, it's non-taxable because it's not considered income that you're getting back.
This is great, Susan. All right, look for these things, proof of purchase, look for those coupons, and save them all, right?
And save them
all. Sooner or later, you're going to want something.
And then when you're in the supermarket,
look for... You can also trade.
That's right. I used to trade at my bowling game. We used to trade at bowling or in the library. They have a little trading box of coupons and refund offers. That's
a
very good idea.
Great, Susan. Thank you. We will continue and wrap up with Susan tomorrow, cashing in with coupons. Thanks, Susan.
Oh, thank you. You're